What's up, Kim Foos? This is Kimchi.
And Tofu.
Yeah! This is the final episode for Season 3 Attack on Titan.
No!
Yes, it's more like a no.
No! Yes, we have to wait one more season, and then it's the final season.
Yeah, so it has been confirmed.
That's the no part, yeah.
That 2020 Attack on Titan Season 4 is going to be the
last. Dog.
It finally comes down to it, huh? Season 4?
Yes. Very unfortunate, but I'm excited to find out what the conclusion
I hope the conclusion outcome. Yeah, the outcome is really good. Like I said, I don't think we're gonna get a good happy ending.
No.
But we'll see. Here it is, the last episode for Season 3 Attack on Titan. Thank you guys for joining Kimchi and Tofu. As always, let's go
and start the show.
Yeah.
For the sake of the freedom it fights, the Titan fights.
Shingeki no Kyojin! Attack Titan!
Which is him.
Man, so this means like Historia gotta be a Titan though. And that's not what he wants. He does not want them to. He wants to protect her.
Yes. Don't make those same mistakes.
Damn, all these memories just tied into one core. Yeah, there's no way they can announce it to the public.
No way.
No way, dude. They find out that it's people they're going against. Yeah, actually, that's right, because the king did that.
Yeah, why hide it? Yeah, exactly what he did.
Yeah, they're going to announce it. Screw it. They're like, if we're going to go in and do this, we got to go all in.
That is true. Bring strength within everybody.
Dude, they're going to really let everyone know.
Yep, newspapers is out.
Wow, so the whole history, the truth is let out to the public.
Yeah.
Dude, this guy looks so good in a suit.
He does.
Wow. Man, they call it the race of devils. Whew.
We're going nuts finding this out.
Now you see some laugh it off. They're just...
They must not believe it, yeah. Conspiracy. They won't be laughing when they really find out.
Oh, yeah. Next time, put an article that will say, yeah, give him some more credibility, guys. Yeah, that's true. And then they find out that it's their blood.
Mm-hmm.
That's so crazy, right? Like, the thing that you fear and hate the most is in your blood.
Yes.
Wow.
And it's not understandable because you feel like everybody's normal.
Hey, you heroes of the wall. Man, that's right, because he thought about her right before his death too, right? Gosh, so he still looks at Armin like it was a waste. Wow, was everyone thinking that? No, man. Yeah, a lot of people do think that though. It should have been Erwin.
It's not all because of emotion. Actually.
Yeah, it was more of emotion. Because if you go with facts, Erwin should be had been the choice. But in the long run, I think overall, Armin was the right choice. It's just we need some time for them to see it. What? Gave up in the end?
This guy just doesn't shut up.
It's because like he hasn't seen their side with Armin. He doesn't see like the brain or the intellectual knowledge of Armin or anything.
Seems like he's growing stronger. It's not as weak as it was from last time. No, I'm talking about this guy. So he's saying that Armin is not worth dying for where Erwin is worth dying for. Levi's listening in on this. Well, they need to give Armin his chance.
He's telling him exactly the thing that he told him.
Yes.
Right. Wait.
He's seeing the flashbacks.
Grisha's sister.
Yeah.
Oh, gosh.
It's not exactly free outside in the outside world either.
It's just the nature of humans, right?
They're not free till the Marleans are defeated. Oh, this is a
damn,
reward.
That is true. Was it hope that they found or is it despair that they found?
Things just get harder from here.
It's just like a new beginning. So he has to find a way to do this without having her turn into a titan, but...
Oh.
Whoa.
Oh! So he didn't just eat her. He came to try and seek help. Oh my gosh.
And she didn't do it because of the king's memories and stuff, right? Yes. And Eren's so... Oh my gosh. So now he finds out that his dad tried...
His dad,
to negotiate with them. Or
yeah, he didn't just come in straight up attacking them. He asked for help.
So the wall memorial was all cleansed with titans, so there's no titans there anymore. Wow, so it's like they took it back and just restarting from here.
Yeah, nice.
Gosh, look at that damage they did. Holy so cow. Much. Well, I mean, to be fair, the colossal titan was in there, so... Right?
Yeah.
Are they going to make it to the sea? Because it's an island.
Oh, yes. Right? Yes, yes.
Wait, so they don't have any of those little titan soldiers anymore. They wiped them all. Dude, his hair grew long. Oh, shoot. He looks like a different person.
Maybe he's trying to look like his dad.
Right? Just give him some glasses or something. Oh, wait, hold on. The birds. That means they're close to the sea.
Oh, yeah. The birds. The sea. Oh, red flares. Titans.
Oh, whoa. What is that? Little... Whoa, what kind of titan is that? Wow.
Follow the trail. Wow, he looks weird.
Right, he looks different.
Oh, it was a patriot. So it's another one of them trying to save. He was able to touch it and find out, though. That's different.
Yeah, follow the trail.
Oh,
man. Is this a desert?
It looks like at the sand. You remember the sand?
They experienced something new.
Yes. Walls. This is where they get dropped from.
Oh, they made it. They made it. Oh God. And Eren should know exactly what this is.
Yes.
And beyond that is Armin. It's right there, Armin. It's right there.
See.
I'm so happy that Armin's gonna see this. Like, I'm happy for Armin.
They all get to see it. Mikasa and Eren, too.
Oh, dude, Armin.
Behold.
They did it.
They made it look so beautiful, too.
They freaking did it.
This is just confirming everything more and more. The desert.
You got to see it.
Yes.
You got to see it, Armin.
Put the seashell to your ear. Hear the ocean.
Salty. Salty. Yeah, it is. Man, Armin has to feel like a blind person seeing color for the first time or something, you know?
Yeah.
It's huge.
Levi was first like, it might be poisonous. Don't touch it. He's so cautious.
Dude, this is such a nice scene. I told you, Eren. Yes.
Yeah.
Gosh, all of them look so older.
Yeah, they do.
Wow.
So we have to cross the sea?
Of course, we're on an island. We have to go there.
I wonder how far they have to go.
Beat them up.
So that means they need to build a boat. It's just more people trying. Yeah, it's
our enemies. It's not freedoms.
Nope, it's more lands.
He's saying like the freedom is like it doesn't stop. There's still more stuff after another. You're not totally free until all of them are defeated. From the scorching desert to the open sea. Whoa, was that sniper? Oh no.
Guns.
Oh, okay. I was like, wait.
Showing the wars.
Wow, these were just wars.
Can I meet? Wow.
Who are these guys?
Is this like the future? Like the wars will continue as they progress and they keep going forward and onward?
Is this saying like history's gonna repeat itself?
Over and over?
Who are those kids in the uniform? Are those in the Marlies or?
The only thing I can see them as is people from the future.
they're from the future and this is going to happen again no matter what, if Titans or no Titans.
Yeah, it's just wars, fighting people fighting against each other because of fear.
None of this basically is not going to stop until all Titans are gone.
But the pictures that they showed, there's no Titans fighting. So I feel
humans
like
humans fighting against humans.
Yeah, it's humans fighting against humans. So no matter what, there's going to be wars in the future. Is that just human nature? Yeah, it's human nature, maybe.
Yeah, because they all have uniforms on too, right?
Yeah.
Man, Eren, he's completely out of his mind now. Yeah. He's like, remember Game of Thrones? Bran, when you know more,
it can be bad.
You're like a curse of knowledge.
Yes.
You know, it's like when you know too much, that's when it starts devouring you.
And because you can't talk to anybody, you can't say anything because
nobody understands where you're coming from.
No, A, nobody understands. B, they can misuse it and then turn it against people, like what he fears for Historia. That's why he can't. He has to keep that to himself.
But that's making him more go crazy more, is because all of this, he's dealing this with himself. He has nobody to vent to. He has nobody to talk to this about. And he sees everything. So,
yes.
Eren in his mind, he's the whole total chaos.
And maybe this is what they're referring to about like the whole wise king or whatever, the old king, you know, right. How it always reverts back to him, you know, being stuck in his own ways and doing things his own ways because of the fear of what he's already seen or what's already happened. And that's why they're fighting to leave things as it is. Probably because they gain so much knowledge. Just like you said, they have that, you know, expansion of knowledge to know everything, but they keep it to themselves. And then everything like the Attack Titan, he knew who Armin and Mikasa is, so he could see the future. So maybe the Wise King can see the future too, and that's why he keeps things the way it is.
Oh, you think the Wise King did that because it's not gonna stop, and that's why he just wanted to just be secluded in a different, in a island, and just live peacefully. They don't want any more of this. That's until the Marlies came back and attacked again.
Yeah, that's the only thing I can think of.
Eren can get the memories of Historia.
Yeah,
when he touched her.
Yeah, he was able to see the memories, but it seems like she didn't see anything because she's just looking at him like, what's going on? But then she kind of like,
right? Whoa. So she wasn't able to see him, but he was able to see hers.
Yes.
And the last time she was able to see Ymir's on the letter.
Connections. I don't know what that's all about, but he was actually able to see his dad's side of the story when it came down to what happened that day. So instead of thinking that his dad was horrible just for going and killing them and taking the powers, but more so he's been finding out, okay, my dad had a good cause for it. He was trying to, you know, for justice.
He knows the truth.
He knows the truth. But now he knows even more. His dad tried to talk to them before going to attack. And it looks like he protected himself too. He had to. It looked like almost...
like they were about to attack him?
Yeah, the Wise King, or, you know, the sister, she looked like she was about to rage.
Because they don't believe in his...
points of view.
Points of view, saying that, no, we're fine as it is right now. Armin finally got to see the sea.
Him, oh, man, that Mikasa was a really good scene. And Eren together.
I'm happy that Armin got to see it because he was the one that's always preaching it. Like, guys, you won't believe what's out there.
If you look at the books, they showed us the books again in this episode, and it shows us exactly what you have to do to get to the edge. And like, it shows the exact landscapes that we're seeing as they are crossing to there. So somebody made that book for them.
So it did show getting to the sea.
It showed the sands, the water, and that's the path that they took getting there. They crossed the sands and then they got to the water. It was like kind of like a map, like this is what you're about to cross and then you'll get to the sea. And then from there, the memories from what Eren has and the other books is the connecting ties. This is what's past the sea.
I think the problem right now that these guys are facing now is that we always thought freedom was what's being beyond the walls.
Yes.
And then until you realize that your problem just got way bigger. Now, what does freedom really mean? Now that you're past the walls, you see the ocean, but are we technically really free? And I think freedom comes with freedom of fear. And I think that's what all boils down. And I really wonder, man, that if that scene, the student scene, is actually the future.
I feel like that's the future.
That's the future.
Because that looks too futuristic. I mean, right? the school forms, the preparatory, like, well, doesn't it?
Well, what about if it belongs to the Marlies?
Oh, yeah. You know what? It could belong to the Marlies. Yeah.
No, but wait a minute. Hold on. But at the same time, the kids in the uniform, they were in Juan Maria.
Yeah.
Oh, shoot. So it is the future.
Probably. Yeah, because now they're about building up Juan Maria. They're taking back. They're getting rid of the Titans. They're cleaning up. So this is their time to build up. And now that they know that there's like stuff that's on this island, you remember there's oils, there's resources here. that they can learn.
And this is not going to stop.
No. The thing is the Marleys aren't going to want to change their beliefs and what they give to the people. Remember, the Eldians are segregated. They're put to the side. They're the lower class, you know.
Right, they're not
allowed to be over where the rich people are, the Marleans, because they're dirty. They're scum.
Right.
You know, they're sinners. I feel like it's going to be a war of trying to free their people and maybe bring the Eldians over, but that's not going to... I feel it's just going to be total chaos.
It's going to be total chaos, and it's going to be more of, we're going to be seeing humans against humans. Oh, man. Yeah. Can you imagine, like, later down in season 4?
Yeah.
Humans against humans shooting each other, and on the background, you have Titans just freaking... Oh, what, dude, can you imagine that scene? Right?
Yeah.
Humans all fighting on the ground, and Titans all fighting... Wow, dude. And Levi in the back just dishing, cutting up some Titans. How do we close this where both are happy, both it's peaceful? And that's the thing about this whole cycle of hatred, you know, it never stops. Equality. I mean, how can we get equality?
How was it for the Germany, the Nazis and the Jews?
Well, the United States came in.
Yeah, somebody else came in. So is this where the island of Walmaria, our island comes in? We're small. We don't have all these upgraded, updated weapons or any of that stuff. The only thing we have is Titans, and we don't have them all.
That's true. We only have two Titans.
One, two, three.
Yeah, well, we have three Titans, two in Eren, one in Armin.
And then we have Annie.
No, Annie's in the Marleys, with the Marleys.
No, she's underground in the island.
Oh, freak! That's right! I totally forgot about that. She's underground.
Yeah, so we have four.
Ymir is the one that's in the Marleys. So we have four.
Yes.
So it's 4 against 5. But wait, hold on. We don't even know the 9th one, though. So it's technically 4 and 4 right now. So it's basically, it is balanced. Unless we wake up. We have to wake up Annie, though, but it is balanced right now.
Yeah.
But not technically balanced because we do have the strongest one.
We do. No, we don't.
Yes, the Founding Titan. But the problem with the Founding Titan is that we have that power, but we don't have the button to push it.
We can't unleash the power to its fullest because
Historia is not a Titan.
No.
Yeah. So.
But I don't know. Maybe just touching her without her being a Titan could do it.
No, remember.
He was able to see the past when he touched her. So maybe if he just touches her, there's the electricity.
Yeah, so, they're able to see it. But the thing is, in order to use the power, he needs to touch a Titan form bloodline. So that person has to be Titan form.
Does it have to be Titan, though?
Well, I mean, Eren does say that, can there be another way?
Yeah, that's what I'm thinking is, does she have to be a Titan? Can he just hold her, like, you know, carry her around?
Like on his shoulders and then be all right, go attack that way.
Yeah.
This way. Maybe there would be a way for that to happen, I guess.
Yeah.
I just don't see how they're going to do it. This is what goes on in our world, man.
Yeah.
No, this is the reason why, like, rational, fast decisions can't happen.
No.
You know, it's like it takes time. It takes a long time. This one took years and years. I mean, generations after generations. And it finally comes down to someone actually doing it. That's the thing about politics. I'm sure that what goes on now. It's like, think about it. Right now, Trump just met up with Kim Jong-un. They're talking, hey, until you get rid of your titans, we're not going to have peace.
Yes.
Right? So if you want a good economy, you want everything else, get rid of your titans.
I wonder if he understands the king's viewpoints more and more as he learns more knowledge. Do you wonder?
Do you think Eren is going to get fazed by it?
Do you?
Oh, shoot. If that happens, that's not good.
Because you said, he's changing and he does have the founding powers.
And what if he does think like the king and be like, dude, this is going to repeat itself? Not that I do want to see that, but it'll be pretty cool to see someone with so much ambition he was the chosen one. Mm-hmm. You're supposed to be the chosen one to balance, you know, to create this balance, not join the other side.
Yes, but he wants to protect his people too.
Exactly. He wants to protect his people. Not really join the other side, but he wants to protect his...
He wants freedom.
He wants absolute freedom.
Yeah, he wants absolute freedom.
Not just freedom of outside the wall. He wants absolute freedom. Yeah. That's why I'm saying, if Eren's mind does change because he knows so much and he sees so much, can a person like that who thrives and is so ambitious for absolute freedom, can it really change his mind as well? I honestly think Eren won't turn out like that because he has Mikasa and Armin.
I don't know. From what I'm seeing, just kind of how Eren has been this whole time, like he's been going back and forth, you know, before he found out about the truth about his dad, he was like saying, kill me. I don't deserve this power. You know, this was your guys's. It's not my fault.
Do you know exactly what it means? History repeat itself. Who was the protector of the king?
Ackerman,
right?
Yeah.
If history repeats itself, who's the protector of Eren? Ackerman. Another Ackerman. Mikasa Ackerman. So this can... That's what he's talking. Repeat itself. Kenny Ackerman was next to the king the whole time.
Yeah.
He was his, like... Like, yes. Next to him, he knew everything, right? History repeats itself, and if Eren goes with the king's ways, it's the same thing. Another Ackerman...
Next to him.
So Mikasa is the next Kenny, and Eren is the next king. If it repeats itself...
Well, we have two Ackermans. We got Kenny... I mean, we got Levi and Mikasa.
Yeah, but I'm talking who will be next. The one next to the next to the guy 24/7. Love is that one universal power that nobody can understand that can change a lot of things. Love.
And Mikasa loves Eren.
Love has to do something huge. Why do you think Owls told him? Love.
Love.
Love him. Don't let history repeat itself. Love is a universal, some force. It's an energy force that it somehow ties in with this dimension physically. It's weird.
Yes.
So people can't really explain it, but that's what love is.
And it's the connection that always brings us back together.
Exactly.
Yeah.
So, all right, cool, guys. That was the last episode of season 3.
Yeah.
The other side of the wall. No. Well, at least the good thing is that we don't have to wait a year.
Next year, confirmed.
Yeah, next year confirmed. But guys, thank you guys so much. We are now moving into the summer anime. So we hope to see you guys for our upcoming summer anime schedule.
Yes.
Thank you guys so much. And we'll see you next time.
Yes, we'll see you guys next time.
Bye. Bye.